mwenye mchifo chio right honorable speaker of parliament of Uganda mkana wefe mkae uliano prime minister wenziwe Masaba pastor Daniel ukweli chilo mche chia moyo Iba kule mbeze mwesu wali ano kusingira dalawa ikilagi. Nabi kweyele nabi, nigamani gosi, tuwela nyalawa dabu sana kuna kule chelelo. Mwanya la lugari. Luna kulunonga yesu mgani chile. Bebi ya fayo. Ela kusobile kuti nukubani u. Ni my right honorable speaker of parliament mwene nechesa kolichira hii akusindike representative atenda kusindikira mukana ino wewefe kade kuno kuchikupira kumbasi bama sabali yalo mwesi nikuba sima na timwanyara kupa bufunisi buno wekutangirira Bama Saba, angombuga wenye. Eleni ni ilamulondi kuba sima. Ya inomba wele. Baba kuchiti kino kuba na kutukuteleza Bama Saba. Wele ninyabonje lezika we. Bishopu. Rutaya na gani chelani yolo maati. Wale venga ichi kuzahari. Alo mnu mbresi ni kukola. Nasenga mchiki kuda kukanika mufugire sana banyule nabagerema ewa ewa ni nyanu nabagerema aleti mudoma usomeso mutendeke yaratere oni kibi na kisfaranga bati nabagerema foundation ngana mu muyere na Funa no mjini kwa mamu mofisi yo emori mori. Elamu protocol nini kuma njula kubanga avero mjini ezele mu mchitifwa chewenga emori mori. Kale ina mulomba wa sabu ni wati hatu mufigiri se in Jerundi. Can you stand up for recognition? Again in a special way, unafigiri sa, I want to introduce, where is he? Pastor Can you stand up again? You, yes. Daniel, what time was it? Who could see the chino mo? Chino no kule chelelo. Era kuele where we sagit information. Kaka ni kabusabi tu ta bingili la busata wada. I am impressed by his way of doing things. I thank you so much. Na di chilebe chuo na kufanya mulo anga. Naluwe siru gisuru mbusa gila. Sese nalomba. Isome uruzungu. Ni wazaba gani chile. Vaisi, I mean, right honorable speaker. Wanga vitu vya Bama Saba. Vinimubu wanika. Nibiga mauli lebu. Waleka kubi yelanga vile lighted. So I read. The right honorable speaker of Parliament of the Republic of Uganda. The right honorable prime minister wenziwe Masaba, honorable ministers, the religious leaders, honorable members of parliament present here, LC5 chairpersons, the mayor of Mbale City, RDC's distinguished guest ladies and gentlemen. Giving all praise and honor to God who brought us here this morning. I am honored to be with you here today in this East Monday. I'm clocking 6 months in office as Umukuka 3 of Bama Saba. That means Bagiswe Rumu Uganda, Nibabu Kusu, Be Kenya. With vast challenges, I've taken over this office, but there are so many challenges. This breakfast is dedicated to prayer and all of us believe in, and I need prayer. On a special note, I want to appreciate the Right Honorable Speaker of Parliament of Uganda, Anita Annette Among, for honoring my invitation and by sending a representative to this function. This is a historical breakfast prayer service with the people of Bugisu region. We are charged with the obligations to serve the Republic of Uganda in different capabilities or capacities. But Bamasaba, I am more proud of your outstanding leadership achievement at Parliament of Uganda. I'm extending services near to your people. This can be exhibited of the recent involvement in Bukelea. We thank you. It is wonderful to see all of you, the dignitaries, my friends, sons and daughters of this soil, who are here today as a true testimony of unity in the region and the seriousness you attach to your cultural institution and the faith. Father, I acknowledge with much thanks the dedicated servants of God that I had the chance to interact with, who are none other than the interreligious leaders present from Mount Elgon, and especially the Honorable Minister of Interreligious Affairs, the retired Bishop Junubu, who have been unbelievably gracious to me for organizing this historical breakfast prayer service. I do appreciate with humility. This institution is moving ahead with our new strategy, and I emphasize, with our new strategy to partner more closely with religious leaders and faith communities as we carry out our cultural development agenda in this region. We have started with the covenant Masabalan through today's prayer. As leaders of at all levels, the problems we face are diverse during our course of duty. The pressures are enormous, and both the liabilities and opportunities are greater than any one of us as leaders ever faced. In such a time, the parameters of a mere human endeavor become more apparent than ever. As leaders, we cannot depend solely on material wealth, on our military might, or on our intellectual skill or physical courage to see us safely through the depths that we must navigate in the months or years to come as leaders. And this can be, in Lucasen, is what our pastor, we need faith, and that's why we're here. We need the faith with which our ancestors did pass it over to us, which the faith has been undertaken for the glory of God. We need the faith with which our founding fathers of this great nation of Uganda proudly proclaimed the independence of this country to what seemed at that time as an almost hopeless struggle, bringing their lives, their fortunes, and their sacred honor with a firm reliance on the protection of divine providence. We need the faith which has sustained and guided this nation for all these years. We are all builders of the future. And whether we build as public servants or private citizens, whether we build at the national or local level, whether we build in foreign or domestic affairs, we know the truth of the ancient Psalms: except the Lord build the house, the labor in vain that build it. I reflect on this prayer breakfast to serve as a most useful cause in uniting Bamasaba. And that's my cardinal entry point. And Ugandans, all on the occasion when we look not to ourselves, but to above for assistance, I think it is appropriate that we should not on one occasion be still and consider where we are, where we have been, what we believe in, what we are trying to work for, what we want our region and our country to be, what our individual responsibilities are, and what our national responsibilities are.
this Bugis region and the country has carried great responsibilities, particularly in the years since independence. And I think that willingness to assume those responsibilities has come in part from the strong religious conviction which must carry it in a sense of responsibility to others if it is given. Nearly every public document of Uganda, we find our motto for God and my country. Down to the present day, under my leadership as a Umukuka, I have dedicated every Easter Monday, every year, to be the breakfast prayer day where we shall assemble for prayer and for our celebration. This is not an occasion for feeling pleased with ourselves, but rather it is an occasion for asking to help to continue our work and to do more. This is a region which has this feeling strongly. This is this feeling. This is, I think, a source of strength to all of us. I want to commend all that you do, not merely for gathering together this morning, but for all the work and the works that make up part of our Christian and Islamic commitment in this region. I would like to acknowledge Ba Masaba as owners of this great land upon which we are meeting for the first time ever for a spiritual tradition on prayer. I pay my respects to my celebration of prayer. This is, as I look around through the congregation of all faith, a meeting of every tradition and text. It is also a celebration of the unity of modern and multicultural Bugisu. We may pray in different languages to different deities, but as Ba Masaba, we speak with one voice. We observe rituals from other parts of the world, in temples, in churches, synagogues, mosques, but as Ba Masaba, we all stand beneath one flag and one Umukuka. We worship many faiths, but as Ba Masaba, we all share a common belief, the belief that everyone is welcome and everyone is equal. It is the creed that runs through all our faiths: love for our neighbors, loyalty to family, and help those in need, like perhaps many of us in public life. Like indeed, like most of Ugandans, of course, it is not for me, nor I believe for anyone to co-opt their particular faith in their service of political point. Instead, for me, faith is always be personal guide, a keeper of my conscience. That's why I managed to organize this function, that we should come together as people who believe in God to share our conscience. So this morning, I would suggest perhaps that there is a higher duty we all, as Muslims, Christians, Pentecostals, the Buddhists, etc., etc. There is a duty of respect, of love, of compassion, and care for all who share our common destiny. A duty to embrace others for whom they are, not judge them for what they are. This has never been more important than in trying times for our Bugis soul. There is a danger where the recent people have twisted the faith and have distorted it where it is used as a wedge and where sometimes used as a weapon to destroy ourselves. So that is why I also get pissed up. In a free society, we may choose to define ourselves by our faith, but we must never seek to define or exclude others because of their faith. Let this be the greatest shared goal that we choose today as Ba Masaba. As Ba Masaba, we stand stronger. We are bigger, braver, better than fear, division, and suspicion. Let this be the open, generous, and opportunistic Bugisu region we pledge ourselves today and always, now and forever. Now, let me also use this opportunity to raise issues of our notification. As Ba Masaba, our community, we need to address the vital importance of paternal presence in children's lives. It is noted that single parents have increased from 20% to 30% by 2023. Father absence from homes has serious implications ranging from undisciplined children leading to destroyed social fabric of society. They do lack moral guidance among them and also have lower life prospects than their peers brought up in the two-parent families. The street children and those in remand homes are because of the single parenting. I want Mama to take that one. This is a serious mess it deserves. Now, the population census is in May. This is a very important exercise where I invite all clan leaders and local government officials to sensitize the communities to ensure that all citizens take this exercise very seriously and mobilize people to be counted. Once we know our population, as Bamasaba, it is going to be a great asset to us as a cultural institution in decision-making processes in terms of focused development and economic transformation. Another thing I wanted to talk to you, the population here, is gambling. This is a terrible thing and very destructive to our young generation who have become addicted to betting. Over 1,000 stupid, I'm calling them stupid students from Makerere University lost their academic progression last year because they gambled their tuition fees and their future has been curtailed because of betting. I appeal to leaders to come up with ordinances to check on this advice. The University of Mbale, I request honestly the Right Honorable Speaker to ensure that Bugisu has been very loyal to all these governments from the time of independence. We even contributed money before we got independence. We should not be treated in that manner. I respect government has a very sharp ear. Let's kindly, let's speak of parliament, expedite the process of ensuring that Bugisu as a region secures a public university in the shortest time possible. As I summarize today, we profess the principles we know to be true. We believe that each of us is wonderfully made in the image of God. We therefore believe in the inherent dignity of a human being, dignity that no earthly power can take away. And central to that dignity is freedom of religion, the right of every person to practice their faith how they choose, to change their faith if they choose, or to practice no faith at all, and to do this free from persecution and fear. I'm saying this because of recent, we had such scenarios where people are being persecuted because of many issues. So I since the Honorable Right Honorable Speaker is here, we should not tamper with people's rights. Our faith teaches us that the face of suffering, we can't stand idly by, and we must be that good Samaritan. In Isaiah, we are told to do right, seek justice. In conclusion, members who are here, let me join you in seeking God's grace in all our lives. I pray that His wisdom will give us the capacity to do right and seek justice and defend the oppressed wherever they may dwell. I want to thank all of you for the extraordinary privilege of being here this morning. I want to ask you for your prayers as I continue in this awesome privilege and responsibility as Umukuka 3 of Baba Masaba. May God bless Baba Masaba, Uganda. God bless all those who seek peace and justice. Ladies, you are not going to be able to do this. Kali nalomba mukuyete kubona kuti kwafunire inyanga ye wangu ye kubona omukuru dali awene obona omukuru mulamukuru amatukuru kuza mu America nomba members of parliament babukisu I think a source of strength to all of us. Ni nyumupe rekisa mwa mukasi mwa kaka kajenda sengi ni sikarana mutu ni mamba ni memba mduera ku kachiko kei university kujende nai wanga ni mbeko yupoza kuyera kuyera wa masaba kada ni awe neo e kulombe mai uinche ogani che kwa masaba wanyala kutegeleza.